Hey everyone, this right here is an accident detection car project made using Arduino Mega. As the car starts, the LCD displays the various car parameters in real time. Right now the speed of the car is set to 0 using this potentiometer. This is the X, Y and Z coordinates of the car and this is the temperature right now. It also detects the vibrations and displays the message "car is vibrating" when the vibrations exceeds a certain threshold. Now let's see what happens when it is met with an accident. As soon as it hit the other car, I received a text message here with a live location of the area where the accident took place. It is very crucial to know the car parameter values when the accident happened so that the engineers can analyze the data and reason for the accident. For this, there is a black box system installed in all cars which is usually hidden in a very safe location. This black box is shielded in such a way that it can withstand harsh environments such as fire or explosion. To imitate this, I also have a black box here at the bottom of the car. The SD card module here saves the car parameters data as soon as an accident is detected. Let's plug it into our laptop and analyze the file. Here we have an accident detected message followed by the orientation coordinates of the car at the time of the accident. The speed of the car was 70% of its top speed, the temperature was 31.4 degrees Celsius and vibrations due to the impact is low. The latitude and longitude value gives us the exact location of the accident. This data is very crucial for engineers to identify the source of the accident and rectify the issues, if any, in future cars. Before moving forward, I have a very exciting announcement for you. Now you can purchase these types of projects directly from us. We will provide you with the complete kit you need to build these projects with step-by-step instructions guide. Also, if there's any project that you need help with or just want to consult about a topic, my team is here to assist you in every step. For more details, check the description. Let's look at the components you need in order to build this project yourself. Arduino Mega here is the brain of the car, which processes all the inputs and outputs. I have used three sensors to gather the car data, which are vibration sensor, accelerometer and temperature sensor, whose data is being displayed on the 16x2 LCD in real time. You can use more sensors if you want, such as an encoder, gas and fire detection sensor to make this more real. The GPS module here detects the real-time location of the car and GSM module sends its coordinates to the designated mobile number via SMS. The potentiometer here imitates the throttle of a real car. Using it, you can change the speed of the car. The Mega takes the input from this potentiometer and changes the speed of these four DC motors accordingly. L298N motor driver is used for interfacing the motors with the Mega. At the bottom of the car is the SD card module as already explained in the demo section. The car runs on four 3.7V lithium-ion batteries which are also installed at the bottom. All these components are assembled on an acrylic chassis. You can use any other type of chassis that you have. This is the schematic of the project. You can download this on our website. The link is given in the description. Now let's go through the program quickly. Several libraries are included for various components such as LCD, accelerometer, temperature sensor, SD card, GPS module and GSM module. I have included all of them here. Global variables. Pins for sensors, LEDs and other components are defined. Also, instances of classes for sensors and modules are initialized. Setup function. It initializes serial communication, LCD, accelerometer, temperature sensor, SD card, GPS and GSM module. It also sets the mode for SMS text messages. Inside loop function. This is the main execution loop of the program. It performs the following tasks repeatedly. 1. Reads GPS data and prints latitude and longitude if available. 2. Reads accelerometer data and temperature sensor data. 3. Checks for overspeeding by reading a potentiometer value. 4. Checks for vibration and temperature thresholds. 5. Controls motor speed based on the potentiometer value. 6. Checks for accident conditions using a custom function and logs data to an SD card if an accident is detected. 7. It sends SMS alert for overspeeding and accidents. Now here I have defined some important functions. Is accident detected? This function determines whether an accident is detected based on predefined criteria such as high acceleration values or high vibration. logAccidentData function. This function logs accident data to a file on the SD card, including accelerometer readings, vibration status, temperature, and GPS coordinates. SendSMS function sends an SMS message containing a specified message to a specified phone number using the GSM module. So guys, that's it. I hope you like this project. Again, if you are interested in buying this one or need more help with it, check the link given in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.